advantages of us. We have great sports and music, we have culture, we have food and restaurants. And
hello, everybody. This has Come Dine With Me, Western New York. I'm Russ Salvatore.
And I'm Jan Farrington. And living in Western New York certainly has its advantages, Russ. We have great sports and music. We have culture. We have food and restaurants. And
I don't know. Let's speak about restaurants. I'm the restaurant man, you know.
Okay. Take it away.
We've got the finest restaurants. I've gone out to eat in Florida, Los Angeles, so forth. None of them shine our shoes. We got chefs. We got Ball Jenkins. We got Hutch. We got the chef at Oliver's. I can go on and on and on. And Mr. Orazio, the greatest Italian restaurant. We are very fortunate to have these people with us, Jan.
That's right. It's all about the people. And you know, there are three people who also love Western New York. They are our celebrity chefs. Chefs Art Christie, Krista Van Wagner, and Marco Shortino. And Marco, why don't you lead us off today?
Hi, Jan. The chefs are with the Chase family today. This beautiful kitchen. Art's going to be making his steak au poivre. Krista's doing an amazing crab cake with beurre blanc sauce. And I'm going to be finishing up with Colleen with some chocolate peanut butter cupcakes. But first, let's see what Krista's got coming up.
Coming up in today's show, I have the honor of working with Pascal. He's a renowned pastry chef from our area. He's now at the Gatehouse Grill, not only as a pastry chef, but he's also doing the appetizers. Today, he blew me away with pan-seared scallops with a southwestern cornbread dressing, and he made it so simple, you can do this at home.
Hey, Russ and Jan, I'm starting things off today, and I'm with Milton Kousandreas and his special guest that we have today. Who is it, Milton?
I'm very proud to introduce to you my mama, Maria. She's going to show us how to cook a Greek dish called pasticcio, which is a baked macaroni dish. It's pasticcio to the Greeks like lasagna to the Italians. Very similar dish. And mama, welcome. You want to start?
Yeah, thank you.
We're starting by sautéing onions.
I see those are nicely, finely chopped onions,
yes.
Right, Maria?
Yeah. Yes.
Mm.
And very,
of course,
tasty.
And I'm sure you've learned all your cooking techniques from Mama.
I did, but it's kind of tough because my mom, when she cooks, she never uses a recipe.
No measuring spoons,
no
everything.
No measuring, nothing. Everything is by feel and touch.
Yeah.
And I got to be there when she cooks and write the recipes up.
Yeah.
And we've done that over the years. And we use many of her recipes today in the restaurant.
I think they have special spices or something in their hands somehow.
It seems
when they cook it, it just comes out.
And you know what the best thing is? After she's done cooking an excellent meal, the whole family is over, and you tell her how good it is, her remark is always, well, this time it didn't come out as good as I would have liked. You know, next time it will be
better.
It's
going to be better.
Yeah. Okay, now that the onions are sauteed, we add the ground beef.
Once again, everything carefully measured, right? So, Mama, tell me, who's really the boss in the kitchen, you or Milton?
Now Milton. For many years, she would come there and cook for us. Lately, she's been taking it easy.
So when you cook in the restaurant, you cook like you're cooking for family, right? So what we're going for is we want the beef fully cooked, and as fine as we can, so we don't want big chunks and lumps in there.
Yes.
Is that correct,
Milton? That's true.
Okay.
Now we're going to add to that a little salt. Black pepper. And one more spice that goes in here is ground nutmeg. Just a touch, maybe half a teaspoon of nutmeg.
A little cinnamon.
Cinnamon?
And a touch of cinnamon.
So that's the secret spices, I see,
Now we're adding some tomato paste to finish it off.
Now that tomato paste is going to add a little sweetness and a little natural thickness to it, Milton.
Is that
how that works?
Okay, so this is all done. So always got a taste. Oh, let's see.
It's okay. It's good. It's Mama Maria approved. So. Okay, now that we have our ground beef all nice and brown, we're going to start with our bechamel sauce. We have a little bit of whole milk and some butter. Maria's added a little bit of salt, correct?
Yes.
And then a little bit of nutmeg, just to get the right amount in there. And then we're going to take a roux, which is nothing more than equal parts of fat and flour. And then you can use butter, is probably the best, more traditional way. And you have to make sure that you have the milk hot. You want to add hot roux to hot stock or hot sauce, and that'll give you the thickening component that you're looking for.
We're going to crack some eggs. About 5 eggs is what we do now. Okay.
So now we're going to take the scrambled eggs, we're going to add it to the bechamel, correct?
Yes.
Nice and slowly so it doesn't, and the bechamel's not real hot so it doesn't cook the eggs, which will just blend it just exactly the way you want it. Look at that. Wow.
Okay, next step, we have some macaroni that we cooked here, and we're going to mix our macaroni and our ground beef together. All of it?
All of it?
Yeah.
Okay.
And we're adding a little Parmesan cheese to this.
Okay,
and mix it all together.
That smells unbelievable, I gotta tell you, it really does.
We're ready to go in the oven, 1 hour, 350, we'll make it nice color.
Mmm. So Maria, Milton, I don't have to travel to Greece to get true, authentic Greek food.
No, you don't. If you want to taste more of my mom's cooking, come to Eltan's on Walden and Union in Chicktawaga, or our second location at Transfer Road at Seneca Street in Nelma.
Come dine with me, Western New York.
This portion of the program is sponsored in part by Artisan Kitchens and Baths. See, touch, feel, and use our products. And by Russell's Steaks, Chops, and More. Be my guest. Let us do the rest.
Be my guest, let us do the rest.
Put your tax return to work, because the time is now to transform your home. The Vinyl Outlet provides custom fabrication with the best railings and decking installed by the finest craftsmen, committed to deliver the look you deserve. The Vinyl Outlet provides virtually maintenance-free vinyl fencing for the look your yard deserves. Take advantage of our early bird special and save up to 35% off. The Vinyl Outlet, let us transform your home.
Welcome to Molinaro's. All our Italian cookies are made from family recipes passed down from generation to generation. Nobody can top our hand-tossed New York-style pizza, right, Dad?
That's right, Maggie. When they want a good pizza, we got them a cover.
Try our signature dishes like chicken Molinaro or enjoy authentic Italian classics. You know what we always say? Quando mangiate con Molinaro, mangiate con familia. When you eat at Molinaro's, you eat with family.
Savvy businesses know the best way to bring customers to the table and add dollars to your bottom line is with a clear and consistent marketing message. Learn how to put the power of television to work for you on Wednesday, April 3rd at Russell's Steaks, Chops, and More. We'll demonstrate how a well-crafted television campaign can work for you. You'll also learn insider tips on choosing the top channels at the lowest cost. Take your business to the next level. Call Key Video at 884-5391 to reserve your spot today.
There's been a lot of debate over which is better for you, artificial sweeteners or sugar. And I'm here to tell you, it's just the battle of two evils. Sugar is filled with nothing but empty calories, meaning higher calories with no nutritional value. Sugar causes blood spikes and lows, promotes fat and weight gain, stimulates appetite, high cholesterol, and promotes inflammation. On the other hand, artificial sweeteners may save you on calories, but they increase your appetite for sweets and carbohydrates. They also promote fat and weight gain. They are nasty chemicals that the body is simply not meant to ingest. So when it comes to artificial sweeteners or sugar, you're really picking your own poison. I'm Dr. Jamie Brennan with just a few more hints for your health.
Hi, I'm Adam Goetz from Sample Restaurant in Allentown, and you're watching Come Dine With Me, Western New York.
I'm honored to be here with Pascal from Gatehouse Grill.
Good morning, good morning. Thank you.
I am excited about your recipe today. We're doing scallops with a Southwest cornbread dressing, and it's got layers, so we better get started.
Absolutely.
Layers.
The first thing we have to do is prepare our cornbread. It's a quick and easy recipe, as you have. We start with our wet and dry ingredients, putting in all our dry ingredients.
May I? Baking soda, flour, sugar.
And cornmeal, of course. Now we have our wet ingredients, a little buttermilk, one egg, and a small amount of butter. You would treat this like you would any pasta, just stirring enough till it all comes together. There you go.
All right. All right, and may I ask, why buttermilk?
It has a great tang to it. When you're dealing with seafood, you want tang. You want something to cut through that seafood-like quality, and buttermilk works very well for that.
Now that's fully incorporated.
Yes, and we have a prepared dish sprayed with a little bit of pan spray.
May I tell the audience, this is very important. I do not want your cornbread sticking.
And our baking temperature is 350.
But how long?
About 15, 20 minutes. Went to the touch, when it springs back, you know it's done.
Let's get started on that stuffing, that dressing.
Of course.
For this, one of the many levels of this recipe. I just love it.
Very good. Then now that we have our cornbread prepared, we can start sautéing our vegetables. We'll start off with a little bit of a clarified butter. Add our onions. You know, it takes just minutes. We just want these to soften up and get nice and rounded. We'll come in with our garlic.
Never too much garlic.
Not in this recipe. And we're fortunate in this area to have corn, ripe-made and beautiful corn, which will add to this.
You took this right off the, you shucked this yourself.
Yes, I did.
I could tell.
Yes, I did.
You.
Now we'll add a few more vegetables, our celery, carrots, and a couple of little surprises here, a little poblano pepper, which I've grilled, seeded, and cut. And it adds a nice, soft, smoky flavor to it all.
I love that. I love that smoky. I'm adding all of this. Is that okay?
That's great.
All right.
And finally, we'll finish the dish with 2 ounces of venison sausage.
Well, let's get that sausage in there. All right.
Good.
What he did was you just took the casing off.
Yes,
okay?
Exactly.
All right, that's good. Is it a spicy venison or?
What it adds more than anything else is a wonderful gaminess.
Ooh.
And when you think of a product like this, it's not the gaminess, but the way that they make meats now, the wild game, they're very soft and rounded. And we're fortunate
True.
To
True.
Have at the Great House, at the Gatehouse Grill, these products that we can serve to our customers.
And another thing I love about the Gatehouse Grill is it's casual. It's comfortable.
It is.
And you really work on the service end of it.
Very much so. Our service persons are well trained. I want them to use the right words, the right language, the right flavors to describe to our customers what they're having for the evening.
Well, I think I'm all sauteed out here.
Very good, then.
Tell me next, Chef.
Now we'll add our cornbread.
All right.
And we'll just give that a simple toss.
Okay. Okay, here we go. You ready?
Yes.
Oh, this is really feeling good to me.
Now we'll add a little salt and pepper and dried oregano.
Dried oregano it is, and just a pinch. It's dried. Salt, any special? Looks like kosher, sea?
It is sea salt.
Sea salt. I'm
and we're going to finish it off with a little chicken broth.
Hey,
just to moisten it all up.
Oh, maybe that's enough.
That's beautiful.
That's beautiful. Now, can I see that pepper mill over there.
Oh,
fresh ground black peppers.
Exactly.
Yes, would you mind?
Not at all, dear.
Fresh is best. That is there, just great. Yeah. Thank you so much. I'm looking forward to putting all this together.
And can that smell, that, isn't that wonderful?
And the color.
Exactly.
The color is beautiful, and how well this is going to work with those, the sweetness of those scallops.
Exactly. For an appetizer, you don't want too much food. 2 to 3, about 2 ounces per serving. We'll season them with a little sea salt, fresh cracked pepper, and pan sear them off in a little bit of olive oil. The thing about scallops is that overdoing them could be the worst thing ever. So as far as the cooking time, I suggest 2 to 3 minutes on one side, and then I turn them over, turn the heat off, and let them finish themselves.
Thank you, that sounds good, and you are right. So many people overcook those sea scallops, so that is the best thing we can teach you today is don't overcook these. Get that caramelization, put it in a hot pan, and that's how you work with these sea scallops. I love how that chipotle sauce just brings the whole dish together.
And would you call it memorable?
This dish is memorable. And I thank you, Pascal, from my heart for being here today. Well,
thank you, dear. Thank you. Gatehouse Grill, 8220 Main Street. Come dine with me, Western New York.
This portion of the program was sponsored in part by Buffalo Hotel Supply. Design, deliver, and install. We can do it all. And by Diamond Cutters of Western New York. Buy direct from the Diamond Cutters.
Let Diamond Cutters of Western New York save you money while providing the very highest quality, beautiful diamonds. From the mines to a ring, a diamond may change hands many times before it reaches your finger. Each middleman adds a little more cost to your diamond. But for the past 30 years, our gemologists have traveled the world to bring rough diamonds back to Buffalo, where we specialize in cutting and polishing on premises, so we virtually eliminate the middleman. Diamond Cutters. We cut diamonds for their beauty. We cut the middleman to save you money.
Some say it's our amazing sports bar. Others, our relaxed and comfortable dining room. And then there are those who say it's our private meeting and banquet rooms where we take care of everything. Whatever draws you to Buffalo's best grill and catering, one thing's for certain, you'll always get a great meal. We pride ourselves on our casual atmosphere with very comfortable prices. Buffalo's Best Grill and Catering, Southwestern Boulevard in Orchard Park. Stop in today and see why we're Buffalo's best.
Ben Fantaski, where would you like to have dinner tonight?
Well, Russell's, of course.
Be my guest. Let us do the rest.
When you think Orazio's, think choices. From authentic Italian and fresh seafood to spectacular specials. When you think Orazio's, think homemade. From fresh bread and desserts to made from scratch pastas. When you think Orazio's, think tradition with more than 20 years as a Western New York favorite. And when you think Orazio's, think tonight. Orazio's Restaurant. It's not like home. It is home.
Welcome back to Come Dine With Me, Western New York. Remember, if you want to learn more about any of the restaurants that are on our show,
or you saw one of our chefs prepare a special dish that you'd like to make on your own, you can find all the recipes on our website, comedinewithmewny.com. Up next, our chefs are headed to South Buffalo to invade the kitchen of the Chase family.
We moved in here when I was a kid. I was probably 4 or 5 years old, and my parents bought the house and grew up here until I was college age, went to college.
There's no other place I would really want to live. There's just a real sense of community in South Buffalo.
South Buffalo is kind of like the Amish. You're related to someone somewhere.
Just walking down the street, you run into people that you
grew up with, maybe went to grammar school with, high school. I mean, it's just a, it's a neighborhood.
My heart's desire was to see one of my children buy this house.
Once we moved in, we decided that we needed to do some renovations.
Oh, working with Artisan was great. Julie came in, threw down a couple ideas. Once we saw her designs, it was no other kitchen we wanted to do. And the way that Tim and Juan worked with us, it was just unbelievable experience.
Kind of heartwarming to see the kids take over the house, especially as the grandkids grow up and enjoy the house as much as I did.
Mike doesn't much like seafood, and you probably will see that today.
I actually don't like anything that comes out of the water at all.
His wife loves seafood, so his goal today...
I want to make crab cakes for my wife because I have no idea what they're supposed to taste like, so...
We can make them up for his lovely wife.
I do like to bake, and I'm excited to work with Marco today to do some sort of dessert because anything with sugar in it, I love.
You're not going to believe this, but my daughter's girlfriend, who's 12 years old, gave me a recipe for chocolate peanut butter cupcakes. Lydia, this one's for you. It was absolutely a great recipe. Thank you.
Today we made a French steak au pois with tenderloin. Steak au pois means made with pepper.
Oh, that sounds great. I love steak.
Anybody that can help me prepare a better strip steak, I'm all for it.
Today we made crab cakes served with a very light lemon beurre blanc. We started out with eggs, fine diced red and green pepper, jalapeno peppers, scallions, red onion. Cilantro it is. We're going to just chop it. I'm going to let you go.
How much of it do you need?
You know what? Just a little bit. Maybe okay. 2 tablespoons.
I just cut my finger. I chopped my finger off.
But he took it like a man, and it wasn't a problem at all. We put a transformer Band-Aid his son gave him, and he went right back at it. Didn't slow him down at all. Now, if you can just gently add that crab in there.
Sure.
Yeah, let's just get that in there. We pattied them real firm and pattied the panko breadcrumbs right into it. And place it in the oil away from you. We pan-seared that in a bit of canola oil mixed with a little olive oil. Before I flipped it, I threw in a tablespoon of butter, which just imparts all kinds of flavor. The beurre blanc basically is a simple reduction of white wine, lemon. Reduce that down with some shallots, and I just finished it with butter and whisk it in slowly. You can just strain that off over the crab cakes. To the crab.
Cheers.
Hi, I'm here today cooking with Anna Margaret and Mick. And I understand, Mick, this is one of your favorite dishes, steak au pois. You ready for it?
Absolutely.
All right, I'm going to show you a real easy rendition of this. There's 100 different variations. I'm going to show you mine. First, we took a chateau, patted it dry, let it sit at room temperature for about 30 minutes. You should always do that anytime you're preparing any type of a meat product. We sprinkled the sea salt and peppercorns on top of the tenderloin. What we're going to do is we're going to take this and add it to our scalding hot pan. And we're just going to sear that for just a few minutes till it forms a nice little crust. We'll flip it. And then we took some fresh herb, put it on the top, placed it in the oven, cook it to an internal temperature of about 135 degrees, and then we let it rest on the board. We made a simple sauce made out of brandy or cognac, whichever you prefer. The trick here, you always gotta make sure you remove it from the stove because it will and can ignite. And if it don't, we're just gonna do that. And the reason we wanna do that is we wanna burn off all of that alcohol. Took a little veal demi-glace. We added some heavy cream, a little bit of butter to kind of make it a little bit richer. Adjusted the seasoning, added some shallots, some fresh garlic, plated it over on top of the sliced tenderloin.
I have the pleasure of cooking with Colleen in her beautiful new kitchen from Artisan Kitchens and Baths. We're making something that I'm really not that good at. I'm not a baker, but I'm gonna show you an easy way of getting the kids involved and simplifying your life. It's real simple. I kind of cheated a little bit. I used box cupcake mix. You add 3 eggs, a cup of water. But I left out the oil. I added a little mayonnaise. They came out so fluffy. I whipped it up. We're gonna take our cupcake pan and you're gonna add a chocolate peanut butter cup in each and every one of those cans.
Now, will the chocolate melt completely just around it?
That chocolate is gonna get all ooey and gooey inside. Fall in love with that cupcake and you're gonna absolutely love it. Okay, while you're filling that last one, we got our oven preheated at 350 degrees. These are gonna take about 18 to 21 minutes according to the box. When they come out, the frosting is real simple. It's 2 cups of peanut butter, 2 sticks of butter, and 2 cups of sugar. Whip it up, comes out like a mousse. We're gonna finish it with a chocolate peanut butter cup. These are gonna be slap your mama good, right?
Super good.
Slap your mama good?
That's right.
Okay.
I'm using mayo from now on. This is good.
Crab cakes from Krista were spectacular, and of course Marco with his cupcakes, outstanding.
My mother-in-law and my father-in-law, this used to be their house, so it's kind of nice to get to work in the kitchen that they used to work in so often.
All the things that went on, you know, my son doing the crab cakes, and I was amazed that he tasted crab.
I will never have those crab cakes again ever in my life, but I'll make them for my wife.
And it was just great. It was a phenomenal, phenomenal meal.
Great time. I recommend it for anybody.
Come dine with me, Western New York.
Closed captioning provided by STG. STG, revolutionizing point-of-sale solutions.
I love Aloha. It tells me exactly what's selling.
I love Aloha because it helps us stay competitive.
I love Aloha. It's helped me increase my drink orders by 10%.
I love Aloha because it means fewer mistakes.
I love Aloha because the service is great.
Why do so many restaurant owners in Western New York love Aloha touchscreen register systems? Give us a call and see for yourself.
This is Tom Payne to tell you about my new seasonal specials. Try my new upside-down chicken pot pie made from fresh pulled chicken meat and served over a homemade buttermilk biscuit. Or try crispy panko garlic tilapia and shrimp. Come home and try Angus meatloaf with lobster mashed potatoes. And my favorite, short rib shepherd's pie. We braise beef short ribs and then top them with gravy, vegetables, mashed potatoes, and cheddar cheese. Wow. All for a limited time at the Grapevine, 2545 Niagara Falls Boulevard, Amherst.
When you think Volkswagen, ooh, think Volkswagen of Orchard Park. The only Volkswagen dealer that's all Volkswagen, all the time. Think that's cool? We put all certified pre-owned vehicles through a 112-point inspection and give them an additional two-year, 24,000-mile bumper-to-bumper warranty, along with 24-hour roadside assistance. Not bad, huh? Volkswagen of Orchard Park, near the corner of Mile Strip and Southwestern. Think Volkswagen of Orchard Park.
Welcome back to Come Dine With Me, Western New York. We're out of time, but before we go, I want to encourage you to support our local restaurants when you eat out this week. What do you think about that, Jen? We've been saying this for how many weeks? I hope everybody out there in these independent restaurants love us for supporting all these guys, because we're doing a job for them, aren't we?
I hope we are too, Russ. You know, what's better than going out for a wonderful meal? I have to say, I love doing it, and I hope our viewers do too. You know what? We'll be back here on Channel 7 next week at the same time. We hope you'll join us then. For Key Video Productions and everyone here at Come Dine With Me Western New York, I'm Jan Farrington.
And I'm Russ Salvatore. Jan, time to stick a fork in it, because we are done.